Hello everyone, Adam here. So today I'm going to show you something different. What would it be? That will be a GPS car tracker, and not exactly GPS but AGPS. So the AGPS, that would be the position taken from the 2G cellular network cell, and this is going to be sent to your phone, to your mobile phone, after you ring this device that I'm showing you. So this is ultra fucking cheap GPS tracker. So the total cost of this device is under $10. So what is composed of? So this one is having here you have a 5 volt stabilizer. So this is LM7805, two high capacity capacitors, electrolyte capacitors, though each of those is 1000 of microfarads. This is a small capacitor, so it's 100 of nanofarads. 6 diodes, so those diodes they allowing to take the current something like 2 amps. So this is because the another thing that we are using, though, this kind of module, which is basically a kind of computer, this small one is going to take up to 2 amps when it starts up, or whether it goes to the GPRS. So this is why we are having such kind of, I would say, high current stabilizer here. The best would be to attach some kind of head sink to this one, but you know, this is a, I would say, cheap product, so I dropped this. And of course the heart of this device, this chip, which is ATTINY2313, or even it can be something more powerful like ATTINY4313. So the important thing is that this AVR chip from ATMEL, it does have a UART, so the hardware UART, the hardware serial port, which will be basically talking to this device. So what about the cost? So the cost is $3.5 on the Alibaba or Aliexpress for this one. So as you can see I have broken antenna, so I need to solder something to the plate, but I think it works. The chip, which is something like $2, the capacitors and the diodes, which are something below, I think, $3, and the stabilizer, which is something like $1 or maybe less than this, and the PCB, of course, but it can be something, as you can see, it's the universal PCB, so I wanted to cut the cost, so I used the cheapest available. What else? So for the needs of this presentation, I will be using a serial converter from USB to serial port. This one is based on FTD232 chip or something like this. So it will install a virtual serial port in the PC, and it will communicate over 3.3 volt logic with my device. Basically it will show you what this module sends and what my MCU, the chip, sends back to this module. So maybe, yeah, one more thing. So this one will be connected to the 12 volts. Basically it should be connected to the car accumulator, but in my demo I will connect it via ordinary old AC adapter from some old laptop that I had. Okay, so let's start something up. So for needs of this presentation, I have connected device I have constructed with the serial port converters here to USB to the PC, and powered it up via 12 volts brick. So I would be giving 12 volts here, and this whole device will convert it first to the 5 volts, and then via diodes it will drop down to 3.8 of volts, which is the voltage needed to power up this little device, which will communicate with the wireless network and set appropriate information both sides. Okay, so yeah, I'm using PC with Linux, but it can be any kind of, just a debugging here what's happening. So I'm powering up it now, so we'll see what would send this device. So it says the pin is ready, it's functioning, it's call ready and SMS ready. So my device is waiting something like 10 seconds before it sends another information. First it checks whether pin is ready, then it checks whether there is a network operational, then it configures APN and some parameters needed to connect to the GPRS. The GPRS is important because we'll be querying the cell, the neighboring cells, to give the GPS positioning information that would be sent back to you whether you call this device from the mobile phone. So I have also a mobile phone, I will be calling in this. Right, so if it's registered, then we can see that the diode is blinking here. So there's a red diode somewhere which should be blinking. Yeah, and if it's blinking, I would say once per 3 or 4 seconds, it means that it registered to the network, and we can call this one to pull the data and send it back via SMS. Okay, let's call it. So if it's been called, then we'll see something like ring message. Okay, just to show you, I'm calling it. I'm using this pinless SIM card just to, I would say, to simplify the code. But the code I have, it would also accept the some kind of pin, but the pin should be fixed, like something like 11111 or something like this. Anyway, let's call it. If called, it will disconnect the call, so it should disconnect. Yeah, it shows now my number. The device is trying to connect to the GPRS. Okay, so it got connected. As you can see, it now is querying the cell for the location and it sends back the SMS message. Okay, so I got the SMS. Okay, on the SMS I have programmed to send the current location and the link to the Google map, which is fine, yeah, because it shows simply the location when I'm here. So yeah, that's my location. So as you can see, it works. Let's see what my MCU is sending. So I have turned off device. I will now switch the pins to show you what actually my MCU is sending towards the SIM800L module, GPRS GSM module, just to show you how the information are really pulled from this device. Okay, so I'm now switching back the device. So right now it's disconnected. I'm switching it back. So my code is waiting something like 10 seconds to send first AT command. Yes, that's the first AT. Then it turns off the echo. Then it checks whether the pin is needed or not. It checks the registration on the network. And then it configures the APN to connect to the GPRS. Basically, there will be nothing sent over the GPRS, but we'll need this to query the neighboring cell to give the GPS positioning information. Okay, after it is configured, we'll repeat the scenario. So we'll call back the device. So we're calling back the device. The same thing should happen. So it will disconnect. So ATH is disconnecting, then it tries to connect to the GPRS. So we can see the device is blinking fast with the red diode. We are polling the location. We are sending SMS. And I will be receiving this SMS shortly. Yeah. I have the SMS message right now. Okay. So that's how it works, and it works pretty well. So I just wanted to remind you that it costs less than $10 to construct this one. Maybe I'll show something what about the code. Because we are using the smallest device, the smallest MCU, then there are some, I would say, challenges in the code. For example, we have only 2 kilobytes of memory. So we needed to encode almost everything within the prog memory just to poll and compare, because otherwise we would have a stack overflow or something like this, and would be very difficult to make this kind of program. Okay, we are not using any kind of I would say interrupts here, so we are just polling and sending the data from the UART directly without any kind of buffering. The only buffers that we need are the buffers to compare the outputs from the modem, from the SIM800L and from the MCU. Basically, the code is very, very simple. The only thing you need to, I would say, be careful are the delays and checking of the responses properly. I also used some code to make a delay from the assembly language from this page, because I found that the delay MS function from the AVR library is working bad, so I need to borrow some code. But anyway, like you already saw, we are sending commands to check the pin, to check the network if it's available, and when there's a ring message from the modem, so when there's an incoming voice call, we are disconnecting the call and we are connecting to the GPRS, opening GPRS PDP context, and check GPS parameters and send it feedback over the SMS. That's all. So if you want this code, please subscribe, and when there will be something like, I don't know, 1k of subscriptions, I will give freely the code and the diagram of this device. So bye bye, thank you very much.